Welcome dear children to e-learning classes. Today we shall continue with the unit number 2, how the dog found himself a new master. Today we shall be reading the chapter. Before you read, you must know that the dog and the wolf are closely related. You may also know something about how over the centuries human beings have domesticated and tamed wild animals. Here is a story about how the dog became a tame animal. Unit 2, how the dog found himself a new master. Dogs were once their own masters and lived away wolves do, in freedom, until a dog was born who was ill-pleased with this way of life. He was sick and tired of wandering about by himself. Means the dog was ill-pleased, means he was not at all happy wandering alone, means roaming alone, looking for food and being frightened of those who were stronger than he. He thought it over and decided that the best thing for him to do was to become the servant of one who was stronger than anyone on earth. And he set out to find such a master. He walked and he walked, and he met a kinsman of his, a big wolf, who was as strong as he was fierce. Now you all know that wolf is a wild animal and he is very violent. He looks like dog only. So when the wolf saw the dog, he asked the dog, "Where are you going, dog?" The wolf asked. "I'm looking for someone to take up service with. Would you like to be my master, wolf?" "I don't see why not," the wolf said. And this agreed upon, the two of them went on together. Now both of them, they were master and servant. They walked and they walked, and all of a sudden, the wolf lifted his nose, sniffed, darted quickly off the path and into the bush and creep deeper into the forest. The dog was much surprised. "What's come over you, master?" he asked. "What has frightened you so?" "Can't you see that's a bear out there, and he might eat up both of us, you and me?" Seeing that the bear was stronger than the wolf, the dog decided to take up service with him, and he left the wolf and asked the bear to be his master. The bear agreed to this readily and said, "Let us go and find a herd of cows. I'll kill a cow and then we can both eat our fill." So now bear was the master of this dog, and what bear said that we will go and kill a cow and we will both eat together. They walked on and soon saw a herd of cows, but just as they were about to come up to it, they were stopped by a terrible noise. The cows were mooing loudly and running in a panic in all directions. The bear looked out from behind a tree, and then he too ran hastily deeper into the forest. "Now, why did I have to come here?" said he to the dog. "It is the lion who rules the forest in these parts." "The lion? Who is he?" "Don't you know he is the strongest beast on earth?" "Well, then I'll say goodbye to you, bear. I want a master who is stronger than anyone on earth." And off the dog went to ask the lion to be his master. The lion agreed to it, and the dog stayed with him and served him for a long, long time. It was a good life, and he had nothing to complain of, for there was no stronger beast in the forest than the lion, and no one dared touch the dog or offended him in any way. But One day, the two of them were walking side by side along a path that ran amidst bare cliffs. When all of a sudden, the lion stopped. He gave a great roar and struck the ground angrily with his paw with such a force that a hole formed there. Then he began to back away very quietly. "What it is, master? Is anything wrong?" asked the dog, surprised. "I smell a man coming this way," the lion said. "We'll better run for it, or we'll be in trouble." "Oh, well, then I'll say goodbye to you, lion. I want a master who is stronger than anyone on earth." And off the dog went to join the man, and he stayed with him and served him faithfully. This happened long, long ago, but to this day, the dog is man's most loyal servant and knows no other master. So with this, we have completed our chapter. I hope, dear children, you have understood it. Please go through the reading. Thank you.